Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. If you guys are new here, hi, I'm Panda and welcome to my channel. So today's video, I am going to be doing a get ready with me / pregnancy update. I know I haven't been making any pregnancy updates, but I chose to do one now, which I am 23 weeks pregnant. So yeah, let's get started. So I am 23 weeks pregnant. Today I turned 23 weeks. I turn a week every Tuesday. But right now I'm going to be talking about how my second trimester is different from my first trimester. And if you guys don't know how trimesters work, it's basically like your pregnancy. There is like three trimesters. So your first trimester goes to your first week to your 13th week. And then your second trimester starts at 14 till 27. And then the third starts at 28 till you give birth, basically. So that's a little bit of how trimesters work. And yeah, pregnancy don't go by months, it goes by weeks. So that's just a little disclaimer there. I mean, a little info. I don't know how to speak, okay, I'm sorry. So yeah, so my first trimester, it was the worst. Some people don't have any symptoms, which they're lucky, and some people have symptoms like vomiting, all that through their whole pregnancy, which I feel bad for. But my first trimester, it was like really, really bad for me because I just kept throwing up everything that I ate. So like and I kept, like, what I've noticed was that I was going to the bathroom a lot and also throwing up a lot. So that's how my first trimester went. I just couldn't eat anything. Like, everything that I ate, I wanted to throw it up. So it was just like a difficult time for me, because the few weeks of pregnancy, it's the worst, and a lot of people will even tell you that. So if you guys are pregnant or already had a baby or something, you guys went through this, like throwing up a lot in your first trimester, then you guys know how horrible it is to be in that situation. So I'm just gonna kind of skip my, like, I'm just gonna like try to skip doing my eyebrows right now to get to the good part, because it's gonna take forever for me to do them, to fill them in. So be right back. So I'm almost done. But yeah guys, that was like basically the symptoms that I had in my first trimester, which annoyed me so much because I hate throwing up. Like, I'd rather go through stomach pain, all that stuff, than throwing up. I don't know, I just don't like throwing up at all. And then I feel like, obviously when you're throwing up, you feel like you can't even breathe, like you're drowning and stuff. So I hate that feeling, and I end up crying a lot. So for me, throwing up is the worst for me. So the first trimester wasn't it for me at all. And it kind of affected when I used to work, it kind of affected me during work, because I really had to run to the bathroom to throw up after I ate something. And it kind of sucked, because like I was like really, really, really hungry. Like, I just wanted to eat in peace, but I just couldn't, because each time I took a bite, I would just end up throwing up, and it just kind of sucks. So yeah, the first trimester was horrible. So my second trimester is 100 times better than my first trimester, because I'm not even that big yet. And also like, me throwing up is not happening anymore, because I don't know, because I know people are different in the pregnancy. Some do end up like throwing up a lot, you know, in their second trimester. But for me, I stopped throwing up. I felt better. I had my energy back, because in my first trimester I felt lazy. I just wanted to sleep all the time. I wanted to lay down all the time. I didn't want to do anything. So your first trimester, you're gonna be really tired and really lazy. Sometimes I even sleep the whole day, which is crazy. But yeah, so in my second trimester, I felt more energetic. I was able to eat anything I wanted, and it was amazing, because I don't really have that much, like, that many pregnancy symptoms in my second trimester, until the very end, which I'm about to talk about, which is, I am 23 weeks pregnant, so I'm almost, you know, almost there. I'm basically kind of in the middle. I didn't really felt nauseous anymore that much. Only when I brush my teeth, I just gag. Ugh, I hate that feeling. But other than that, I was able to eat good. I started doing exercise, you know, because a lot of people don't talk about this when they're pregnant, but you know, doing exercise is really important because, I mean, my mom and my doctor also told me that it helps you through labor a lot. Like, it becomes more easier than not doing anything at all. So I just like to exercise, which there is an exercise video that I like to watch. I will link it down below. If you guys are pregnant, it is perfect for you to try that workout, which I really loved. I tried other workouts, but I didn't like it as much as the one that I'm doing right now, which I do it every day. I do take breaks like Saturday and Sundays. I really don't do it because those are the time I do go out with my family. But on Monday through Friday, I do work out as much as I can, and I drink lots and lots of water. But the only thing about my second trimester is that I do get like stomach cramps, and oh my god, the round ligament pain sucks, because it feels like you just stretch something out and it just hurts like a bee, like around your stomach area. It could be like around your bottom right or your bottom left, but that's something that kind of hurts. But I'd rather go through that than throwing up. So yeah, so basically just my second trimester, it isn't that bad. And what the new symptoms that I'll be getting right now, the new ones, is that, I mean, not really new, but I got it like around the 22nd week or something like that, the 21st week. I've been getting like shortness of breath. Before, it wasn't, I did get a little bit shortness of breath, but not as much as now. Like, I feel like I just need to take a breath every second, but you know, I'm trying to do better. I mean, exercising does help a little bit, because you just get your energy running, and you know, I don't know how to explain it, but yeah, shortness of breath, and also my back pain, which just sucks so much. I just hate back pains, and you get also like leg cramps a lot. Like, you guys have no idea. Like, I've been getting leg cramps like nonstop. It sucks because I've been sitting down on the couch, and then I just stand up and start walking to the kitchen to get something to eat. My leg cramp starts and everything. But like I said, exercising does help a lot. You know, if when you're starting, I will suggest you guys to start slow, and then because it could give you cramps, leg cramps, because trust me, girl, I remember when I first exercised, I went all the way, and the next day I couldn't even walk, I couldn't even sit down. It was just my cramps in my legs just killed me. So I will say to start slow, and then you know, you could keep going and keep going. And obviously, if you're in your third trimester, or if you have a big belly, just be careful, because I don't want you guys to get hurt at all. So yeah, so my second trimester, it's not bad. Prefer going through it than throwing up in the morning. And if you guys are throwing up still, I'm sorry, because I know my mom, she said with my little sister that she will always throw up. Till she gave birth, she felt better, which is like crazy, because you know, I'm not going through that, which thank God I'm not going through that. But yeah, and there is a pregnancy app that I am using, which is Pregnancy Plus. I don't know if you guys have heard of it. Maybe you guys have, because I know bigger YouTubers use that app that are expecting, because oh my god, I almost choked. Because I know I started to use it because PETA, I don't know if you guys know Makeup by PETA, she uses that app. She recommended it, so I started using it, and it is an amazing app. Like, you could just, you know, put how many weeks you are and like your due date and everything, and it would just pop up there, and every day they give you articles for you to read and things that you might be going through during pregnancy, and it helps you a lot, you know. And you get to see how big your baby is in your belly, like the size of a fruit, cats, or food, I don't know. But yeah, so it's a really good app. I would totally recommend that for you guys. And it is free. I know you have to pay for some stuff, but not that important stuff that you have to pay for. It's just extra stuff that you can use that you have to pay for. But it is free and it is a very good app. Like I said, I do recommend it. And yeah, it's just kind of funny how each time I film, I wear this shirt. It's just kind of crazy. So yeah, guys, take care of yourself. If you guys are expecting, sorry if I can speak well, pregnancy brain is a thing. Like I said in my last video, it sucks. Oh yeah, and other symptoms, I totally forgot to mention it. You do get really clumsy, but me, I've been a very clumsy person, like always my whole life. But me being pregnant has worsened it, I think. Like, I am dropping everything, and it's harder to be picking up things, especially through cracks around the house. And what I mean by that is because when I was getting this video ready, I was getting my brushes ready because I did wash them the night before. And some of them kept falling, and it was just a struggle to be getting them, like, out of the cracks of the, like, by the cabinets where I was drying on top of the cabinets, so they kept falling in the side, like, I don't know how to explain anything. So basically there's a wall and there's a cabinet, so in the crack they kept falling, and I had to like scoot the cabinet over and try to grab my brushes, and it was just a struggle because like I sweat a lot, I'm always running out of breath, and it gets annoying. And then, like I said, when I was getting my video ready, I keep going to the room to get more things to get, because I keep all my makeup in my mom's room, and I kept getting everything, and I kept dropping and dropping and dropping things, and I was just getting so mad, and to the point where I grabbed a bag and just slammed it against the wall, which is funny because I got really mad. I was getting tired of me dropping things, and it's just annoying. And yeah, people, like my sisters might not believe me, because they think I'm exaggerating through my pregnancy, but they never been pregnant before, so what do they mean? Like, I always thought people will exaggerate as well, like, but it's actually so crazy. Like, being pregnant is not even easy. Like, I just thought you're gonna grow a belly and that's it. Like, damn, you're pregnant, you're gonna grow a belly, you're gonna give birth, that's it. But I never knew you will go to pee so often. I never knew you have to eat so much. Like, you'll get hungry every second, being clumsy, pregnancy brain. Oh my god. Like, it is just too much, you know? But yeah, if you guys are pregnant, tell me down below your pregnancy symptoms. And if you guys are not pregnant, I guess keep it that way. I'm just kidding. I mean, I'm no one to say anything because I'm pregnant, so whatever. I mean, if you're young, I would say just wait. Because, dude, let me just tell you a little something. Me thinking that I was dating an older guy, which he was 5 years older than me. Me thinking, you know, he'll be more mature, more better. He'll be a good person. And he won't, you know, he will be there for me. No matter how old the guy you're dating is, and you think getting pregnant, like, even if you get pregnant, they're going to stick with you. That's not always the case. Find yourself a good guy. Like, really. Like, when I have my daughter, I want to, like, give her... Oh, yeah. I mean, I am having a girl. If you guys haven't seen my last video, I am having a girl. But when I have my daughter, I want to give her so much advice through my mistakes. Because I did effed up a lot in life. But, yeah. Find yourself a good guy. Because no matter what age the guy is, he can leave you. Just like my ex left me. Well, I left him. I actually left him. He didn't left me. I left him because he was very toxic. And I explained it in my first video why I left him. So if you guys want to go ahead and check that video out, you guys can. But yeah, I left him. He's very toxic. But yeah, that's one advice I want to give you guys. Wait, and also find yourself a really, really, really good man. Because I know that even if you have a boyfriend, and you're trying to have a baby together, also think about it, because you guys might get into lots of fights, even though you think, oh, but I'm gonna be pregnant, you know, it's gonna be something different, it's gonna be a new family, we're gonna have a family, this and that. Yeah, it is gonna be beautiful. I'm not saying it's not, but it will, like, you guys can have lots of problems in your relationship, because now you're having to take care of a baby and of a human being. and it's gonna have like a lot of problems are gonna happen. And yes, you guys can fix your problems, you guys can like act mature about it, but it's just a lot, you know. So I'll just say, just be careful, find a good man, okay? But anyways, back to my pregnancy update, because I'm going out of the subject that this video is supposed to be about. Yeah, so, and I'm kind of scared for my third trimester. Why? Because I know your belly grows even more bigger, and girl, like, I don't know, like, I love sleeping a lot. Like, I love to sleep, and it's gonna suck if I mean obviously when my baby comes out, you know, I'm not gonna have a lot of sleep, which I'm okay with that. But the thing is, having a big belly, not being able to sleep on your stomach, not being able to sleep on your back, I miss those positions already. So yeah, your stomach is gonna be blocking you from a very comfortable sleeping position, because right now I could still kind of not sleep in my belly, but like kind of, you know, like, I don't know how to explain it, but kind of like cuddle the pillow and just like, you know, tilt my body a little bit more towards, you know, the bottom of where I'm sleeping. I don't know how to explain it, but yeah, so right now it's not that bad, but I know in your third trimester, it is going to get worse, because your belly, of course, is going to be growing, and it kind of sucks. I mean, not really, because, you know, it's cute and everything. And I haven't been buying a lot of maternity clothes. I mean, I do have lots of like big loose clothes, but I haven't been buying a lot of maternity clothes. So I don't know if I'm gonna have to buy more once my belly gets bigger. I hope not, because I am broke. I'm a broke bitch. I'm just kidding, sorry. But yeah, hopefully my belly doesn't grow that big. And also because when you give birth, I know people still look like they're pregnant, and I don't know if it's gonna be hard to lose that all that big like pregnancy weight because of your baby, you know, it's all growing in there, which I don't mind. You grow a whole baby, so that's just look at the positive. Vanessa, that's my name, by the way, if you guys didn't know that, that's my name, Vanessa. So yeah, I want to name my daughter Valerie because she has the letter V, and just like her mama. Yeah, I'm having a girl, and her name is gonna be Valerie Aurora, and with my last name, which is Ortiz. So she's gonna have the letter V just like me, and I just can't wait to meet her, guys. I don't know, I've always liked that name. It was either Valeria or Valerie, but I don't really hear Valerie much, so I think Valerie is a very cute name. It's like an okay name. So for me, I like it. I like it a lot. But it was so funny because my sisters kind of wanted me to have a boy because it would have been the first boy in our family, because we're all girls. I have three sisters and we're all girls, so my dad kind of wanted me to have a boy as well, my mom too. But you know, my mom and my dad is like, whatever God wants you to have, and as long as it's healthy and good. But they kind of wanted a boy, and I wanted a girl, which is, people were like, why you want a girl if you never had a brother? I was expected to want a boy, but I want a girl because you get to dress them up. I don't know, there's so many cute things, and there's like so many cute outfits out there, guys. Oh my god, it's just amazing. But also like for boys too, there's cute outfits. But for girls, I always wanted to like have them with little dresses and everything. And of course, my mom, when I was going shopping for my baby, I'm gonna show you guys my stuff that I bought for my baby later on in the video when I have more things, because right now I just have a little few things here and there, so I want to make a separate video for that. But yeah, when I was going shopping with my mom, she was helping me pick like baby clothes, and she kept telling me like, oh, you know, like the baby was gonna grow really fast, so try not to get her like newborns or like really small clothes, like get her clothes where she can also wear it in the other month, or you know. So we kept getting her clothes like 6 months above, not newborns, because I know they do grow fast. I mean, I don't know, but I mean, I'm pretty sure they do. So the only thing, we just bought a little bit of clothes, not much, just because I know like I'm gonna have a baby shower, so I don't want to buy too many things and then people bringing me other things. So after my baby shower, I want to see what I actually need, what the people didn't brought me. or, you know, gave me, and shop for those things that I really do need. But so far, I only bought some baby clothes, some bottles, pacifier, and little baby hangers, which I'm going to show you guys that in another video. So yeah, that's gonna be her name, Valerie Aurora Ortiz. And yeah, so I've been doing a little shopping here and there with my sister. So there's another thing that when you're pregnant, I do get a stuffy nose. Sorry, I don't know if I filmed this. I thought I did, but I did put on concealer. I thought I was filming, but then I had to put play. I'm like, what the heck? I'm not filming, so I had to put that. I'm sorry, guys. But yeah, you get runny nose a lot. And I heard that supposedly that if you get closer to your due date, your runny nose gets worse. But for me, it's just whatever right now. I do get runny nose. I wake up in the morning with a runny nose. I have to go to the bathroom really fast to blow my nose. And even when I'm brushing my teeth, I'm like, oh, I have a runny nose. So I have to like blow again, and it's just annoying. But if you guys don't have that symptom or whatever, you guys are lucky, because it sucks so much. Like you're not even sick. You just have a runny nose, you know? Oh, by the way, guys, I really don't use foundation. I just use concealer because I don't know. I just don't really wear foundation because the foundation that I do have is very dark. And the thing is, I bought that around the around the summer, which I'm gonna throw it out because it's been almost a year. So I don't think I'm gonna be using that in the summer. I'm gonna buy a new foundation, and it's darker than my actual skin, because in the summer I do get darker. And in the winter I get light, like really light. Like, I don't know, not too light, but you know, than my summer skin tone. So it just looks really dark. It looks like if I had a like fake face tan in my face only, and it just looks ridiculous. So that's why I don't really wear foundation. And also with concealer, I'm all fine. With concealer, I'm all good. I don't really need foundation. And my skin is not that bad. I mean, is it? It's not that bad for me, in my opinion. I think it's okay. You know, my skin is not that, I don't have a lot of acne. I do get pimples here and there, but I'm all good. It's just my only problem is my lips. They all get crispy and ugly and so horrible. So if you guys have any lip care that you guys recommend, let me down in the comments, because I do need that, because my lips be dry. Even if I put chapstick, they still start peeling off, and it just sucks. Like, how do you even fix that? Like, I don't know. Like, my mom doesn't have that. My sisters don't really have that. Like, why me? You know? That's the only thing I hate. Like, I know lip scrub helps, but a little bit for me, it doesn't really help a lot. Sometimes I just bite my lips. Like, that's weird, right? Sorry. So anyways, yeah, guys. So that's pretty much it for my pregnancy update. Not really nothing big or crazy. I mean, I don't really go through so much, you know, because for feet swelling, they said that I was supposed to get it, but like around this trimester, but I haven't been getting any my feet haven't been getting swelled at all, or my hands. I mean, kind of my hands, maybe, because my ring used to fit so loose on me, and now it's like kind of like not loose anymore. It's just there. So maybe my hand, but my feet, no. And hopefully I don't, please don't jinx it, because I don't want to have swelled feet at all. Like, that's my biggest fear also, because I don't know, like, I heard that you supposedly grow a size, and I don't want to grow a size, because I have these new shoes that I have, and I don't want to like not fit in them anymore, and it's gonna really suck, because I really love those shoes. So I hope not. I pray that I don't get my feet swelled up due to pregnancy. But you know, whatever. It's whatever, as long as my baby's healthy. You know, I'm carrying a baby and everything, so I try to keep myself positive thinking about my baby. Oh yeah, guys, my baby moves a lot. Oh my God. So like, when I'm like trying to fall asleep, it kind of tickles me, because I'll be laying down on my left side. she's always tickling my left side. I don't know why. Each time I lay down on my left side, she starts kicking or moving, whatever, and it tickles my side, and it tickles, like, I'm a very ticklish person, so it really tickles a lot, and I just have to, like, turn around to my right side for her to stop kind of tickling me, because, I mean, it's cute and everything, but let me sleep. But, yeah, it's just, like, very ticklish, and she moves a lot. Sometimes I wake up for her because of her moving a lot. I wake up and I try to turn around to see if she stops, kind of. But yeah, she's just very active. And my mom keeps saying, you know, she's going to be a troublemaker just like you, because I am a troublemaker and whatever. But, you know, sorry that I was a little brat when I was little. I was a troublemaker. I wasn't really a brat, which was a troublemaker. Yeah, so my mom says that she's going to be just like me because she's moving a lot, which I think it's just her saying that. But I'm not going to say, oh, yeah, that's true, I believe it, you know, because it's just her, what she thinks. But I don't know. Once she's born, we'll see how she is. I just can't wait. And I've been having dreams about her. Like, me calling her Valerie when she's crying. I'm like, Valerie, you know. You guys want to hear a funny dream that I had? So I had a dream that my sister's teddy bear was choking me. And she, like, my sister's teddy bear, she loves that teddy bear, she sleeps with it, whatever, it's a cute teddy bear or whatever. But I was dreaming that, and it felt real because I do sleep in the couch, guys. We have a small house, like I said in my last video. I used to not live here. I used to live with my ex, and I just came here because of what happened. But yeah, I sleep in the couch. So I dreamt everything. I dreamt the TV, like everything. Like if it was so normal, like if I was awake and I just grabbed the teddy bear and I was thirsty. So I wanted to drink some water with the teddy bear. Like I sat down on the floor because there's a little small table in front of my couch where I sleep. And I went to it and grabbed the water because I was really thirsty. And then I looked at the teddy bear. Like I was sitting down, like, and I was leaning my back against the couch where I'm sleeping. And I was just getting my water, and I went to the right, and I saw the teddy bear there, and I grabbed the teddy bear, and I was just looking at it, and for some reason, I don't know why, but recé el teddy bear. I don't know how to say rezar. I don't know how to say rezar, sorry. I'm not like Spanglish, but I, you know, persinarlo, lo persiné en el teddy bear. I don't know why. Like, I was like, in the name of Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, amen, to the teddy bear. And then the teddy bear goes and chokes me. And I was like, what the heck? And then I was like, but the thing is, I couldn't scream. I couldn't move. During pregnancy, you're going to have crazy dreams too. That's another symptom. I mean, is it a symptom? I don't know, but it's true. During pregnancy, you have lots of crazy dreams. But yeah, that happened. Sorry my language. But the fucking teddy bear was freaking choking me. And in my brain, I'm like, no. This is a dream. This is a dream. Because in my dream that I thought it was for real, because it felt normal, you know? I just saw the teddy bear. And I did, no, el Padre, el Hijo, el Espíritu Santo, amen, to the teddy bear, you know? And the teddy bear, I guess, got mad and choked me, like, was holding me down, choking me. And then, I couldn't scream. I was like, I was trying to scream in my dream, but I couldn't. Like, I got paralyzed. And in my head, I was like, no, this can't be real. This is a dream in my brain. And then I woke up, like, and I was like, what the heck? Like, oh my God, like, why did I have that dream? Like, isn't me, like, rezándolo or whatever, like, isn't that a good thing? Like, why did it attack me? So then the next day, I told my little sister, she was laughing, but I looked at the teddy bear, I'm like, and I went to the teddy bear and I choked the teddy bear because I was like, you little asshole, sorry, you little asshole, like, you choked me in my dream. And then my little sister was just laughing because she thinks I'm crazy, but that teddy bear choked me. So no, I am not crazy. It choked me to death almost in my dream. And it was just so scary because I felt like, oh, it was just so scary. And it was just crazy. Like, why did I have, you know, the teddy bear? Like, I don't even sleep with a teddy bear. I don't really see the teddy bear. Like, the only time I use a teddy bear is when I'm watching YouTube videos. I just put it on my head. Like, it's like when I don't find a pillow. Because my parents' room, they sometimes keep the teddy bear there and their pillows are flat as fuck. Sorry. Cause I go to my parents' room and their pillows are very flat. So I use a teddy bear for me to lean on. And that's the only time I just see the teddy bear. Like, I don't really see it much. I don't pay attention to it much. So, like, why did I have a dream of the teddy bear? It was just a weird dream, guys. So, guys, I heard that in your next, well, in my next appointment, my doctor said that I'm going to take glucose. I don't know how to say it, but you have to drink a very sweet drink to see if you have diabetes, like pregnancy diabetes. I don't know how that works. But I'm kind of nervous to go because I don't want to end up throwing that up because I don't know if it tastes good or nasty. And my doctor just said, oh, make sure you don't eat for your next appointment, like sweet stuff. Like, it's okay for you to eat some eggs or whatever. I sound like Bretman Rock. Oh, whatever. Sorry, guys. Anyway, so I'm kind of nervous because I don't want to throw up. And I think I'm going to stay there for like an hour. So I'm kind of nervous for that test because because I hope I don't have diabetes, because I know it's going to be kind of harder during pregnancy. Like, I pray to God I don't have diabetes. And also because of the drink. Like, I'm really scared that I'm going to end up throwing up the drink. And you have to stay there for a whole hour. So, I don't know. I'm just kind of scared. So, if you guys have done that test, let me know down below, because I'm so scared, you know, and I just need to, oh my God, there's a skin right there, ew. Anyway, sorry, my lips are horrible. But yeah, guys, I'm just so scared to take that test, and I'm going to go alone because my sister doesn't want to come with me anymore. If you're watching this, I hate you. No, I'm just kidding. I love you. But I'm going to go alone, and I'm just going to be nervous. I mean, I need to calm down, but I'm just scared, you know. It's gonna be a glucose test. Glucose, I don't know. And I know some places they let you pick the drink. I think there's like fruit punch or orange, but I hope she lets me pick, because I heard that supposedly the fruit punch is better than the orange one, but I don't know because I haven't tasted yet. But and then some people say that the orange one is better, which again, I don't know because I don't know. I just don't know which one to pick. Like, which one's better, you know? But yeah, I asked my mom, like, what is that test? She's like, oh my God, it's a very, very sweet drink. And, like, she exaggerates sometimes too much. Is that a lot of blush? I don't know. I don't care. But she exaggerates sometimes her story so much. So, but her exaggerating it made me, like, nervous. I was like, oh God. Like, I hope it's not that bad as my mom says it is. And I also asked my cousin, and she said that it's just like to pick the red one, I think she said. I don't remember. I have to ask her again. But she said it's like a very sweet drink, and you cannot throw it up or it's going to make you take it again. Which I'm so nervous because I don't know. I'm just not really into too sweet stuff. Like, I hate it. Ugh. I don't know. It's like diabetes for me. Like, girl, that's going to give me diabetes. But yeah, just very scary. Sounds like a very scary test to take. You know, I'm putting highlight. I haven't been showing you guys what I've been using. Maybe in my next video, but right now I'm using the Anastasia Dream Glow Kit. So, and I'm using this one right here. I love it. But I haven't been, oh yeah, and the eyeshadow palette that I use is this one, this Morphe one. I forgot what's it called. Does it even say? Oh, I'm so dumb. It says right here. 35V. And it's a very nice palette. I do love it a lot. Sorry, I'm very weird. But I'm starting to get more comfortable me making videos again. Because I used to make videos on my other account. But I'm not going to say which one is my other account, because I hate it. And I, like, if you guys saw my first video, I said why I quit my last account and why I changed to this one. Also because I'm pregnant and I want to make like a pregnancy videos and stuff. I don't know, my life. And my other channel was like more about gaming. But I just played like this one app on my phone called Awaken Life. Now it's popular. Before, I've been playing that game for almost 5 years. So, and even if you go to my account, it says that I've been playing it 4 years, and I'm about to be like 5 years playing the game. So it just became just popular recently, and now I don't really play it much because, I mean, whatever. Yeah, I use my fingers to play highlights. Sorry, guys. But I like this highlight. Like, I don't know. But yeah, guys, I am done. Yes, I'm done. I'm done. I'm done. This is how I look. And I'm not going anywhere today, guys. I just felt like getting ready because I normally don't get ready. And I used to be that person that wears makeup every day, you know? And now that I'm pregnant, I don't really wear makeup because I'm just like, I just want to sit down and watch videos and play my PlayStation and just eat snacks. So yeah, guys, I know this video was like all over the place, but hopefully you guys kind of understood a little bit and enjoyed it. And if you guys did, please subscribe. And yeah, I'm not gonna do it to my lip because the only thing I'm gonna add is just chapstick, which is somewhere, I don't know where it is, but my lip is chapped, so maybe I'm gonna add some lip scrub. And I should have done that first because I feel like it's gonna mess up my foundation around here. But I'm gonna do that later on. But so far, I'm not a professional on doing makeup, like I said. But yeah, guys, hopefully you guys enjoyed my video. And if you guys are new and made it this far, thank you so much. Hopefully you guys can subscribe and follow up for more videos. And I am thinking about doing giveaways in the future. So when I gain more subscribers, I am planning to do giveaways and stuff. Maybe when I reach 100 or 200, 100, I don't know, 500. But that's just a goal of mine. So it will be nice for you guys to help out and everything. And I do want to do giveaways in the future. Which, yeah, you guys, thank you so much for watching, and see you guys in my next video. Bye. Roxanne, Roxanne.